Good morning, Chilwa. I'll be leading your assembly this morning. I hope that you've had a really nice weekend and that you're ready for another fantastic week at school. Today's assembly, we're going to be discussing different feelings and emotions. We all feel different emotions at times. Some of these are good emotions and some of these are not. But they're all okay and it's normal to feel lots of different emotions. So just take a moment now to think about all the emotions you have felt in the last week, the last couple of weeks, and just have a little think. Have you felt happy? Have you felt sad? Have you felt angry? Have you felt joyful? Have you felt rage or scared or disgust or fear? And have a little think about what made you feel these emotions. We're going to watch a video about a girl called Lucy. You've watched a video about her before, about how she's feeling in lockdown. And this one is about her feeling upset, her feeling sad, and that it's okay to feel sad at times. So we're going to watch the video now.
Lucy Pear has wonderful hair. It changes colour like no other. When the sun shines bright and things seem right, her hair is as yellow as that big bright light. When her little brother Brad makes her really, really mad, her hair goes as red as her redhead dad. One day, her friend got a brand new toy.
Wow!
Her hair went green with envy. No sign of joy. When Lucy's excited, full of happiness and glee, her hair goes bright purple for everyone to see. But one day she woke and the sun wasn't so bright. She didn't feel happy. She didn't feel right. Lucy didn't know where to look, and she didn't know what to do, because that morning she woke and her hair was dark blue. She didn't know why she felt so sad, why her hair was so blue, why she didn't feel glad. She didn't want to leave home that day, and she wished the blue feeling would just go away. "Why is your hair blue?" her mummy asked. But giving an answer seemed an impossible task. She didn't know why she felt so low, why her hair didn't have that bright golden glow. Up and dressed and off to school, her classmates thought her hair was cool. Her teacher said, "It's not that bad," but she just couldn't say, "It's because I'm sad." Her friends didn't get it. "Why are you sad? You're always so happy. You're always so glad." "I am always happy." This much was true, but she still couldn't say why her hair was so blue. At lunch, Lucy ate all she could consume, when a sight caught her eye from across the room. Her friend said, "Lucy, look, someone like you." And she looked up to see more hair so blue. She could see he had a smile on his face, a smile so bright no sadness could erase. "But why," asked Lucy, "is your hair so blue? Do you feel the sadness that I feel too?" The boy looked at Lucy with his bright green eyes and knew that his next words could not be lies. "Don't worry, Lucy, if your hair goes blue. We all have days like this. Mums and dads and teachers too. It's important to know. It's okay to be sad. It's okay to be angry. It's okay to be mad. And if you wake up one day and your hair is blue, please don't worry, because that's okay too. We all have blue days, but but it will disappear, and your beautiful hair will again reappear. Tomorrow you'll wake and the sun will shine bright, and today will fade like a dream in the night. That night at home with her mum and her dad, she told them she felt a little bit sad. "But I'll be fine," she began to say, "because it's okay sometimes to have a blue day."
I hope you found that video interesting and hope you realise that it is okay to be sad at times and that everybody does feel these negative emotions. It's important that you recognise your own emotions, and it's really important that you understand why you feel them. So I'd like to show you an activity that we've done in reception. So the children have had a look at the different emotions and they've spoken about how something has made them feel. So when they feel angry, what makes them feel sad, what makes them feel scared, and also what makes them feel happy and surprised and excited. I've got some activities that you can do with your teachers at school or that you can do at home with your parents. So the first one I've got is drawing pictures of the different emotions. Or you could do a photo when you feel those emotions as well. The second one is going through all the emotions and what it feels like, what it might sound like, and a memory of when you felt that way to get you to understand your emotions. And the third one you could do, it's a bit more like a diary. So today, how you're feeling. And you can have a little jot of that in the morning, just to note down how you're feeling that day. Right, I'm going to finish the assembly now with a song, and it's called Don't Worry, Be Happy. And thank you for listening, and I hope that you have a fantastic week at school.
Song I wrote, you might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In this life, you know some trouble. When you worry, you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Somebody came and stole your bed, but don't worry, be happy. The landlord says your rent is late, you might have to litigate, but don't worry, be happy. Look at me, I'm happy, happy, happy. Ooh. got no cash, ain't got no style. You need a friend to make you smile. And don't worry, be happy. 'Cause when you worry, your face will frown, and that will bring everybody down. So don't worry, 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 worry. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy, happy, happy.